Explosive evidence which could lead to Nicola Sturgeon's resignation is to be published by the Alex Salmond Inquiry. The former SNP leader's bombshell submission to the inquiry will accuse the First Minister of misleading Parliament, which, if true, could force her to quit.
The Holyrood Committee is examining the government's botched probe into the handling of harassment complaints against Mr. Salmond.
But he said he would not give evidence under oath unless his submission was published and included in the inquiry's final report.
There had been concerns it may contain information which would lead to the identification of one of his accusers.
But the decision yesterday to make Mr. Salmond's evidence public paves the way for a dramatic showdown in Parliament next week, when he is now expected to appear.
The SNP reacted with fury to the decision last night. It accused the Parliament of jeopardizing a court order to protect the anonymity of the women who had made allegations against Mr. Salmond. But Scottish Tory Holyrood Group leader Ruth Davidson said, "Their clear overreaction only confirms in people's minds that they must have something to hide."
Nobody is suggesting for a second that information would ever be published jeopardizing the complainant's anonymity. That would be totally unacceptable. As the ruling party, it is the SNP's own government who so badly let down women who came forward. It is therefore galling to hear them falsely accuse others of doing the same.
The Scottish Parliament's ruling body yesterday agreed that former First Minister Mr. Salmond's document can be made public following a row between MSPs on the inquiry committee.
It had voted not to publish the evidence amid fears it could breach a court order. But after asking the Scottish Parliament corporate body, SPCB, for a final decision, a resubmitted version of the evidence will be published early next week.
November 2017, allegations regarding Alex Salmond's behavior are raised with the SNP by Sky News. Nicola Sturgeon said she spoke to him about this, and he denied it. No further action was taken.
March 29, 2018, Ms. Sturgeon meets Jeff Aberdeen in her Scottish Parliament office where she has admitted they discussed the possibility of a meeting with Mr. Salmond. Ms. Sturgeon, after initially forgetting about this meeting, says there was the suggestion that the matter might relate to allegations of a sexual nature.
April 2, 2018, Ms. Sturgeon and Mr. Salmond meet at the First Minister's home. According to Ms. Sturgeon, this is the first time she heard of the complaints made against him. Despite this, she has insisted that the matters discussed were party business. April 23, 2018, Ms. Sturgeon and Mr. Salmond hold a substantive phone discussion. During this call, Ms. Sturgeon claims that Mr. Salmond asked whether she would speak to Leslie Evans about mediation with the complainants. A special advisor was in the room at the time.
June 6, 2018, Ms. Sturgeon writes to Mrs. Evans to inform her that she has held discussions with Mr. Salmond.
June 7, 2018, Ms. Sturgeon again meets Mr. Salmond, this time in Aberdeen ahead of the SNP party conference.